On Wednesday, we introduced you to a group of six voters from two key swing districts in Pennsylvania. These voters are an important demographic, white women without college degrees. All say they vote for the person, not the party. Three of them voted for Barack Obama and then Donald Trump. So we wanted to know which candidates and issues interest them this time and how many plan to vote for President Trump. Here now is part two of our Pulse of the People. So show of hands, how many of you have at times voted for Republicans and at times Democrats? All of you. How many of you voted for President Obama and then voted for President Trump? Okay, so Marianne, explain how you were able to vote for both.
I voted for Trump because he was not a politician. You get tired of the same old from Washington, and I really wanted someone that would make big changes.
President Trump, he said he was going to take care of us, and he was going to make sure we had more money in our paychecks and help us out, because you go to work, you work hard, and you have nothing, and then there's people that don't even work that have more than I do.
Has your life economically, financially improved under President Trump?
I have a lot more in my paycheck.
I do have more in my paycheck as well.
My stock portfolio is doing great.
That too. See, yeah. Maybe that's why I look at the economy different. I'm not where a lot of you are financially, I don't think. I'm pretty darn low income. My family has received food stamps personally.
What do you do for a living?
Till recently, I worked at a grocery store. And now I am running a cafe.
Do you think that the economy is doing great?
No. I think the economy for the upper middle class has gotten better, and that's great for them. But the economy hasn't gotten better for me.
Crystal, you voted in 1992 for Bill Clinton. You didn't vote again in an election until 2016. Is that right?
Donald Trump was running. And I said, finally, another businessman, and I got fired up.
Has he lived up to your expectations?
Absolutely. I think he's doing just fine. If he says, this is what I'm going to do at this timeline, he does it.
Well, he hasn't built the wall. That was one of his main promises. So, I mean, do you hold that promise against him?
No, because isn't the whole wall part of getting the money from Congress, too? And isn't Congress stopping him from getting the money? I mean, where's the money going to come from? Is he just supposed to print it right there at the White House?
Well, he did take some from the defense budget.
I think
budget.
It's coming from Mexico, yeah. Was the campaign promise.
I believe that's literally a quote.
How many of you, if the election were held today, show of hands, would vote for President Trump? Okay, one of you would. Lisa Marie, are you on the fence?
I liked him in the beginning when he first came out. He was saying things like it is. Probably saying things like most of us think but don't want to say. But I'm also thinking he's gotten out of control.
That's just him. Watch him from the 80s on. He used to go on the Oprah show and stuff. He's just always been so candid about, I can do that movie star, or I can do this. He's
a reality
he's
star.
He's just Donald Trump.
You like that he's unapologetic.
I like that he's unapologetic.
So in terms of any personal indiscretions, in terms of paying hush money to a porn star, all that stuff, show of hands, how many people are bothered by that? What bothers you?
He was asked, did you, like, I get, just like Bill Clinton, pretty much, did you have sex with this woman? Did you bribe, like, pay her off? And he said no. And it came out, he did. And people are like, you know what, it's not a big deal. But he did lie to us.
There's no remorse. There's no regret. There's no humility.
I don't vote for personalities. I vote for who's going to get the job done.
And why are you on the fence today?
I'm always on the fence until I make the decision. I like to wait for the debates. I want to see who is out there.
But, I mean, there's so many candidates right now. I can't even pretend to know everything about all of them or even most of the things about all of them.
Is there any Democrat that speaks to you or that appeals
Pete
to you?
Pete Buttigieg.
I like Mayor Pete. I mean, that guy, he's a Harvard graduate. He was in the military. Mm-hmm. He's smart. He's just articulate. He has great ideas. He just speaks to me.
Show of hands, how many people like Pete Buttigieg? Marian, is there any Democrat thus far that has appealed to you or that you think jumps out?
Biden right now seems to jump out, but, you know, it can change because I think, you know, they keep saying they're going to bring on someone that they haven't announced yet.
Who's just they?
The Democratic Party.
I didn't hear that.
So I'm just waiting. But it's gotten to the point where you don't know who to believe anymore.
I'm going to be totally honest. Once again, I listen to media. I listen to people here, there, in restaurants. And kind of forming my opinions from other people's opinions. And then I just started researching and looking and looking at different articles and going to Hillary Clinton. I always thought Benghazi, Hillary, that was her deal, the emails and everything. But once you read enough articles and you look at a lot of things, she really didn't do anything wrong, you know? Interestingly enough, I was actually shocked by that, you know, because this is what I heard and this is what I thought.
We are in this polarized world right now where everybody only goes to their own news source that they think that speaks to them.
And I do think a lot of Americans just don't have the time or the energy
or
have the right
interest.
Information or interest. It could be a full-time job for some people.
I think that's really a great point. Okay, so let's lightning round. One word will go around to describe how you see the 2020 race. Do you want to start, Alisyn?
Sure. Polarizing.
Confusing.
Too much information out there, you're saying?
Yes.
Intriguing.
Trump.
I would have to just say change.
I don't know if I can say it in one word. I really just think it's going to be enlightening. Mm-hmm.